What's up, guys? Welcome to my channel. My name is Joel Sam. As always, if you are new here, please consider subscribing to this channel where I post a lot of educational content that will help you become financially free. As I promised you in a video some time ago, I'll be letting you know about other payment solutions besides PayPal that can help you transact internationally, as well as withdraw your funds with virtual cards and what have you. And today's video is one such video I'm going to be creating. I'm going to be teaching you how to create a Payoneer account. Now, what is Payoneer? Payoneer is a transfer solution that enables companies outside Ghana to pay you directly into your bank account. So once you have created your Payoneer account and have made it available to your employer, payments are going to be sent directly into your bank account. It is very convenient. The withdrawal fee per withdrawal is $3, and it is very convenient. There's no hassle. You can easily link your bank account. So this video will focus on teaching you the process of creating your own Payoneer account. Some platforms that accept Payoneer include Amazon Affiliate and Fiverr. Now, you'd realize that these platforms accept PayPal as well, but in the previous video we discussed, we spoke about the fact that PayPal is limiting access for Ghanaians. So if you are from Ghana or you are from another country where access to PayPal is limited, you may want to consider setting up this Payoneer account, linking it to either your Fiverr or Amazon account so that you receive your funds smoothly and without hassle. So without speaking much, let's jump right into the video for today. Okay, guys, so jumping right into it, we are just going to go to google.com and then we are going to go to the address bar up here and search for Payoneer. So payoneer.com. Now, this is the website. Once you arrive here, you hit the register button up here and they would ask you some two questions with the intention of finding the right account for your needs. Okay. I've already explained to some of you that Payoneer is used for receiving funds from companies abroad, okay? So it's not for personal money transfer, it's not like Skrill or like PayPal. It's for strictly business needs. So you have to first select who you are, okay? You are a freelancer or small and medium business, you are an online seller, affiliate marketer, vacation or rental host, individual, whatever you are. I am going to choose a freelancer because I do a lot of, you know, freelance services on Fiverr and other platforms. But if you are into something else, you can feel free to select among the options they have there. So you see right away, they will tell you that you are looking to get paid by international clients or freelance marketplaces. Okay, let's see what the other options have. So if you select online seller, it's the same info you get. If you select affiliate marketer, it's the same information you get. They will tell you, get paid by publishers, networks, and platforms, promote Payoneer, and earn commission, okay? If you're a vacation rental host too, you have that option there. You are looking to get paid by vacation and rental sites and private renters. Or if you are just an individual, there are actually three options. But if you select the second option, which we haven't seen yet, they will tell you that the service is not available for that, okay? This is not a service we provide. Payoneer is suitable for cross-border business payment, not personal money transfers. Yeah, so if you seek to send money personally, okay, maybe to family and friends, Payoneer is not a site you should be creating an account for. It is suitable for receiving funds from companies. So you have signed up as an affiliate for Amazon or some other company and then they need to send you your payments. Maybe you're a YouTuber and you need to receive your payments from YouTube. What Payoneer does is that they are going to give you the opportunity to use their platform to receive those payments right into your bank account. If you're on Fiverr, it's the same. So that is the purpose of Payoneer. It is not for personal money transactions. Let's go to the next stage. I said I was a freelancer. So I'm going to go to the next stage. So hit the register button. And then we want to immediately sign up. So they'll ask us what type of business it is we are into. You have individual, you have company. So obviously an individual, if you have a company too, you can select that, but I am an individual. So I'm going to enter my details right here. My first name, Joel. My last name, Sam. JS Store at
@yahoo.com. And then you'll be required to re-enter the email. And then your date of birth, okay? And then you hit the next button. Then you enter your address, okay? So you have your country here, Ghana. You have your address line. I'm using North Airport Road, Airport West, Accra. And then you have the postal or zip code. Okay. We usually use 233. Those of us who are in Ghana, I'm told that is not the zip code, but somehow it works. So that is what we use. And then you enter your mobile number. So they are going to send you a verification code right away to the mobile number that you have entered. So you enter the verification code that you have been sent, and then you hit next. The next thing you have to do is to enter a password. So I'm going to create a password. So you have to select a security question. When is your wedding anniversary? I'm not married, so let me just select a random date. And then you have to enter your national ID. So you enter the ID number, the issuing country, okay, which is Ghana. And then you enter the code below. So we are going to enter our ID number. Okay, so for the national ID, they have three options. They have the national ID, the driver's license, and the passport. So let me use a national ID and then create a number and hope it works. And then I'm going to enter the code down here, RGCCC, and then hit next. Okay, so I think I have to re-enter my password. I have to select a different password. And I have to re-enter this code. Okay, so at the next stage, I have to enter my account details. Okay, my bank account details. There's a bank account that they are going to send the funds to once I receive them from whichever company has sent the money. So I'll select my account. It's in Ghana. The currency is, you can select any currency that your bank account is in, but I'm going to select GHS because most of us have accounts in the Ghanaian cedi. And then the name of the bank, Stanbic. Account holder's name, Joel Kwesi or Sam. Account number, let's use this one. And then the sort code. So to find the sort code for your bank, you have to Google it, okay? I'll try and leave the document or the site link so that whichever bank you are using, you can easily find it. Sort code for banks in Ghana. Okay, so this one has a list. I'll leave this website linked in the description so that you can locate your bank. But my bank is Stanbic, so I'm going to look in this list for Stanbic. Have I passed Stanbic? Okay, so that was Stanbic. And my branch is Accra Mall. Okay, so this is the sort code for my bank. I'm going to copy it. And then I'm going to come back here and I'm going to paste it. Okay. So you then agree to the terms and conditions, you agree to the pricing and fees, and you submit. So once you are done, they will let you know that the application is completed and they are reviewing your account. So you receive their decision in a matter of days. It's just protocol, you'll definitely be accepted. So once you're accepted, you can use your account, link it to Fiverr, link it to Amazon, link it to wherever you want, and then begin to receive your funds. I'm going to show you something very exciting about Payoneer right now. Yes, guys. So once your Payoneer account has been verified, this is what everything is going to look like. This is your home page. Payoneer is going to give you three virtual bank accounts. one in the United States of America, one in the United Kingdom, a British pound account, and then one in Germany, which is a euro account. Now, what you can do with these virtual accounts is, if you have signed up to a website as an affiliate, or you are working for a company outside Ghana and they need to pay funds into a US bank account or a British pound bank account or an euro bank account, what you can do is you can use these bank account details. You can submit them to the company and it will be paid into those accounts and it will reflect over here. Now, once it reflects here, you just have to hit the withdraw button and then it will withdraw directly into your Ghanaian bank account. It's so easy and so convenient to use. So let's just see what the details of the virtual bank account look like. So this is my US bank account. These are the details. First Century Bank, 525 Federal Street, Bluefield. Okay, that's the routing number. All the information is here. It's a checking account. So if I need to submit it to a company to receive payment in the US, I can easily submit these details and the money will be sent directly into this account, which will then reflect on my Payoneer. And once it's there, I only have to hit the withdraw button and it is in my Ghanaian bank account. So when you hit the withdraw button, you have to select the bank account you are withdrawing to. Okay, and then the amount. I have nothing available right now for withdrawal, but assuming I did, you just have to enter the amount to withdraw and then the amount to deposit. So once you have entered the amount to withdraw, assuming it is $100, it will tell you right away the CD equivalent that is going to enter your bank account. And then you describe it, you give a summary or something, just describe what it is. And then you hit review. Once you hit review and you are okay with the details, you just have to click send or withdraw. And in a matter of days, I think it's 48 hours, the money will be right in your bank account. So I'm just going to take you through a history of, you know, payments, funds I've received to show you that this is real. So I have received funds from Fiverr on several locations. Okay, so this is real, it works, and it is completely legal, unlike PayPal that is not really available in Ghana and creates a lot of problems. This is free to use in Ghana, very convenient to use. Under activity, you have transactions, payment requests sent, manage currencies, funding sources. You know, there are so many options you can take advantage of, and it's an amazing account to have. So that is it. I just want to take you to the phone to show you how the interface on the phone looks like as well. Okay, so I'm going to search Payoneer right there. So this is a mobile version which you can access on the App Store. Remember, you need to create your Payoneer account on the computer or on a website, a PC site, before you log into the app on your phone. So please take note of that. So this is what it looks like on the phone. You have home, a summary of your latest transactions, the various accounts you have, you know, the bank account I spoke about. So that's my US bank account, my German bank account in the euro, and then my pound account from the United Kingdom. So it's a Barclays bank account. Joel Sam, that's my account number, my sort code. It's very interesting. And then this is the transaction tab. This is the actions tab. You can manage your currencies. You can pay to a recipient Payoneer account if you are an employer. You can pay to a recipient's bank account. You can request a payment from your employer or company. You can also withdraw. And then you have cards over here. You can request a card from Payoneer as well. This card works anywhere in the world, and whatever funds you have in your Payoneer account, you can use this card on any ATM machine to withdraw the fund. So that is also amazing. If you want one, you can request it by clicking get started. I don't need this card for anything, so I'm not going to request it. And then under more, you have settings, pending task, legal, support center, refer a friend, sign out. So basically, this is Payoneer for you, an amazing service. I know that this is going to, you know, solve a problem a lot of you are having, because I know some of you out there are YouTubers, and YouTube has now come out with a new policy. They are no longer sending payments to YouTubers via Western Union. Now they require you to enter the details of a bank account in the US dollar. And a lot of you are thinking, how do I get to this bank account and all of that? You can just create the Payoneer account. Once you have your virtual US account, you can use that, fill in the details on your AdSense page, and whenever YouTube sends you payments, it would reflect over here in your Payoneer account, and you can then withdraw directly into your Ghanaian bank account. The same for if you're an Amazon affiliate, if you're working on Fiverr or any other platform, you can either enter your Payoneer details directly if the website or platform accepts Payoneer. If it doesn't and they require a bank account in the US dollar, or from the US or from the UK or from, you know, the European Union, you have these virtual accounts that you can easily use the details, enter it, and then receive your funds smoothly. I hope this video has been educational and you have gotten something for it. Leave all your comments and questions in the comment box below. I'll take my time to respond to each and every one of you, and I'll see you again in the next video. Bye.
Okay guys, thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something new. If you did, please leave this video a like, subscribe to this channel, and stay tuned for the next video next week. I'll see you. Bye.